The yeas are 250. The nays are 175. The motion is adopted. Without objection, a motion to reconsider is laid upon the table.
Despite rumors of its demise, legislation to stop the military's policy of firing people for being gay, that policy of the repeal effort is not dead. It is, in fact, moving ahead at full throttle. Since the repeal effort was detached from the bill that funds the whole military, it's been moving forward as a standalone measure. And today, that standalone measure passed the House. It's now headed to the Senate. Meanwhile, though, the new commandant of the Marine Corps continues to do everything that he can to try to block the civilian decision-making process that is now underway in Washington.
Mistakes and inattention or distractions cost Marines lives. That's the currency of this fight. I don't want to lose any Marines to a distraction. I don't want to have any Marines, and I'm visiting at Bethesda with no legs, the result of any type of distraction.
That was Marine Corps Commandant General James Amis speaking yesterday at the Pentagon. Retired Staff Sergeant Eric Alva served with distinction in the Marine Corps for 13 years. On March 21, 2003, at the start of the Iraq War, Sergeant Alva and 11 Marines in his charge were traveling to Basra. They hit a landmine, which broke Sergeant Alva's arm and injured his leg so badly, the leg had to be amputated. The president awarded him a Purple Heart. He received a medical discharge from the Marine Corps. Sergeant Alva was the first Marine, the first American for that matter, who was injured in the Iraq War. He's also an openly gay man. Joining us now is Marine Corps Staff Sergeant Eric Alva. Sir, thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you, Rachel. Thanks for having me.
Sergeant Alva, the commandant of your branch of the service, the Marines, says repealing Don't Ask, Don't Tell is a distraction that will result in Marines being injured and killed. What is your reaction to that?
You know, I didn't hear about his comments till this morning, even though he made them yesterday. And I was just really taken aback on how disrespectful someone who is the leader of the United States Marine Corps can talk about, you know, members in the armed forces who is aware of that there are gay service members serving in the Marine Corps and all branches of service. But what he did was totally what we call in the military conduct unbecoming. I mean, he literally took my Purple Heart and threw it in my face. I mean, to say that there are distractions and could cause deaths or even loss of limbs for people because of knowing that there are openly gay men and women serving in the military. I mean, this is just unbelievable how someone can really act in a leadership role.
What was novel about his remarks, he has made remarks against the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell before, but to use the existence of wounded Marines as the reason why he, as commandant, doesn't want to repeal was novel. And I mean, not to press the point beyond where you would like me to press it, but as a Marine who was severely wounded in combat, is it particularly hard to hear the argument go in that direction?
It's very hard to hear, Rachel. You know, I lost my leg on the first day of the war, of course, when all types of action were moving forward as we entered the country of Iraq. So what he's stating is that was there inattention and distractions that caused me to lose my leg? I mean, what he is basing his, you know, own views on are his own personal views and values, just like General Pace did, you know, in 2007 when he called homosexuality compared it to adultery. I mean, this is someone who I'm waiting for to get that call from the commander-in-chief himself, like General McChrystal, and maybe take it into that Oval Office and then walk out not in charge of the Marines anymore.
Are you hopeful for repeal, given the House vote today, sir, and the prospect of this heading to the Senate soon?
You know, I'm very hopeful. I've traveled back to Washington, D.C. over the year, working with the Human Rights Campaign, working with service members, Legal Defense Network, you know, both good agencies of people who are on the ground lobbying, who are educating, who are keeping the communication lines open to why we need to repeal Don't Ask, Don't Tell. We still have two wars going on, and there are very, very good patriotic men and women in this country, regardless of their orientation, regardless of the color, their ethnicity or culture, who want to serve their country and who are even have probably perished in the numbers of people we've lost in Iraq and Afghanistan who just, you know, happened to be gay, but it doesn't matter. They were doing their job. I was doing my job that day on March 21st, and that's something that General Amos can never take away from me or anyone else who opposes gay men and women serving in the military. You know, as we state in the Marine Corps, once a Marine, always a Marine, and General Amos will never take that away from me.
Retired Marine Corps Staff Sergeant Eric Alva, thank you for joining us today, sir.
Thank you,
for your service. Really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
As we mentioned earlier, the standalone bill to repeal Don't Ask, Don't Tell passed in the House today. The final vote was 250 to 175. 15 Republicans were among those 250 voting for repeal. That's three times as many Republicans who voted for repeal back in May when the House first voted on it. Joining us now is the sponsor of that House bill, a former Army paratrooper himself, an Iraq War veteran, Pennsylvania Democratic Congressman Patrick Murphy. Congressman Murphy, congratulations on this achievement today. Thanks for joining us.
Rachel, thanks for having me back on. I really do appreciate it.
Let me ask you, before I talk about what happened in the House today, let me get your response as well to General Amos's comments, the Commandant of the Marine Corps.
Well, let me tell you, Sergeant Alva was eloquent in his comments. And let me tell you something about Sergeant Alva. He's an American hero, and he's right in that no one can take away his service and his sacrifice for our freedoms here in America. He is just as much a Marine as anyone I've ever met in my life. And I tell you what, Rachel, you know, the paratroopers from the 82nd Airborne Division in the Army that I served with back in Iraq in 2003, 2004, they didn't care who you're writing letters back home to, if you had a boyfriend or a girlfriend. They care whether you could handle your assault rifle. Could you kick down a door? Could you do your job so we would all come home alive?
You have been able to get the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell successfully through the House twice in one session, which would be remarkable to do it once. You have done it twice. As it heads to the Senate, do you have confidence that this could happen? In terms of timing, it's really down to the wire now.
I do have confidence. And you know why, Rachel? There are Senate Republicans, folks like Senator Collins, Senator Snow, Senator Murkowski from Alaska, and Senator Brown from your home state of Massachusetts, who have now come forward advocating the time now to repeal Don't Ask, Don't Tell. Now, we need to get after it in the Senate. I'm confident they're going to do it. I understand that they must be celebrating Festivus or something, that they can't do any other work. But the reality of it is this. We need to make sure we're doing all we can for our heroes in harm's way. Now is not the time to be kicking them out just because they happen to be gay.
Congressman, you were defeated in this last election. You got 47% of the vote in your home district. Do you think the work that you did on this issue hurt you politically? Was this a political sacrifice for you?
You know, I don't think so. But, you know, my dad was a cop and a Navy veteran. And, you know, he told my brother, sister, and I when we were young children, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. And at the end of the day, you know, I have two little kids, Maggie Murphy and Jack Murphy at home. And during college and about 20 years from now, I want them to be proud of what their daddy fought for when he had the time, the 4 years in the Congress, to fight for our values.
Pennsylvania Democratic Congressman Patrick Murphy, thank you so much for joining us tonight, sir. I hope and expect we'll be seeing you again soon.
Thanks, Rachel. Thanks for always having me on. I appreciate it. And you're a great American still.
Thank you. You're the only person who ever tells me that, but I lap it up every time you do.
And happy Festivus.
Happy Festivus. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.